As you say, it's very important to, in a way, to be active. In another way, to consider that the first session, the first session could be the last session, the only session that you have. And it's interesting to thinking about what is the most important key to use in depression. You wrote a book, is, if I remember, the title is Key for Depression, Keys for Solution in Depression.
I've actually written 15 books, and many of them are about treating depression. The one you're referring to, Keys to Unlocking Depression, is one of my most recent ones.
Yeah.
But the point about the first session might be the only session, you know, that is statistically the most common.
Yeah.
That people will come in for one session and then they won't come back. And so, you know, if a therapist uses that whole first session to just ask about the patient's history, they're missing the chance to do something that will bring the person back by demonstrating to them that therapy can produce changes and can produce changes quickly. That's one of the great advantages of knowing hypnosis.
Yeah.
And, you know, as I travel around the world doing hypnosis trainings for that reason, to help people acquire those skills, because that is such an important part of a first session with any client, but especially with depressed clients.
And if you have to, in that book you talk about, if I remember well, 12 different key to unlock depression. If you have to suggest, you did lecture in over than 30 countries. So if you have to think about one of those key to suggest to therapists, which one is the most precious if you have just one key to choose for help the client you have in front of you with depression?
I think the most important key is the one I've mentioned, positive expectancy. That if the person doesn't have positive expectations for treatment, then nothing else matters anyway, because they won't be coming back and they won't be participating in the therapy. But there are a number of other patterns, and it's hard to really say which one is the most important, because it's different from one client to the next.
Yeah.
One client needs a lot of help learning how to tolerate ambiguity. One of the things that we know from research is that depressed people don't handle ambiguity in the same way that people who are not vulnerable to depression. And by ambiguity, I mean we face situations, all of us, every day, where we have to make decisions about what we're going to do, even though we don't have facts to guide us.
Mm.
You know, should I call this person or shouldn't I call this person? Should I apply for this job or shouldn't I apply for this job? You know, we have to make decisions in the face of uncertainty. And with depressed people, uncertainty invites negative projections. The person anticipates the worst, which is part of what keeps them from taking positive action. So for some people, it's about ambiguity. For other people, it's about their perceptions of controllability. The person doesn't believe that anything in their life can be controlled, so why should they try? You know, why should they go to school? They'll never be able to finish anyway. It's not in their control. Why should they take a job? They're never going to succeed anyway. It's out of their control. And so perceptions of controllability will be an issue for some people. And so when we look at all the different kinds of patterns, it includes things like low frustration tolerance. The person will try something to help themselves, and if they don't have instant success, they give up.
Yeah.
And another very important pattern is called the internal orientation, where the person uses their feelings as the indicator of what to do. And the problem, of course, is when your feelings are depressed, you're very likely to make depressed decisions. And part of what we know is that depressed people tend to make bad decisions that make their depression worse. So, you know, there are many different patterns, and which patterns to focus on will be different from one depressed person yes. to another. There's no formula. There's no one correct way to treat depression.